He does it the only way he knows how. With his massive sports brain sprinkled with a smidgen of rabble-rousing. Let's get back to the Connor Happer Show on 1620 The Zone.
You know, every time it says with his massive, I just get a little...
Where's he going?
I know what it's going to say. It just makes me uncomfortable every time.
Maybe he'll do the old switcheroo and put a new one in there. Nope, not today. Okay.
So we got this question, and I think Matt Rhule addressed it.
Question for
so
you.
John texted into the show.
Hi, John.
He said, we're 10 games into the season. If there are players not playing the defense that is called, why in the bleep is that player still playing? So he talked about how, you got guys in the secondary. He said, I'm paraphrasing all this. I just kind of am taking notes as this went along. He says, that's a veteran secondary that didn't play well in those key moments, specifically talking about the Hartsog play where it went right through his hands in the end zone and then the Tommy Hill play on the sideline. He says, that's a veteran secondary that didn't play well in those key moments. The deep touchdown to Deuce Robinson, that shouldn't have been a touchdown. I expect our cover two safety to play cover two. If we had done that, and then he, kind of trailed off. We're not snake bit. We're not unlucky. You got to play the defense that is called. Those big plays never should have happened. Can't give those up. So there's that. That's one side of the argument. That's one side of the thing. Mm-hmm. And the natural reaction that everybody should have, I think, including Rhule, probably is dealing with this in his head, is, okay, great. Sit him. But you hear how much reverence he has for those players.
He can't bench a single number guy.
See, but it's not like I don't know if you're trying to do that, Josh, but like you make it sound like, oh, I said this guy's this, so he has to be this, right? It's he's not doing it because he anointed these guys earlier in the year as single digit guys and leaders and all this stuff. He says, right out of the gate, he said, I want the seniors to win, but I want them to be the ones to break through. That's why he's not doing it.
Yeah.
That's why young guys aren't playing. That's why Nebraska has not gotten over the hump yet.
He owes them something. Like they worked hard.
I don't think that either. Because if he would have done something. He would have done something if he was just like, well, these guys earned the chance to be here and I owe it to them. No. He wants them to do it. He wants them to do it. Therefore, if it's not them doing it, it's nobody else getting it done.
Right.
He's not trying anybody else. And what he's saying effectively to those people, those seniors, those experienced guys, specifically we're talking about on the defensive side of the ball, is you got two games left. And I'm sticking with you. I'm trusting you. At every turn, everyone has said, you can't play these guys anymore. You can't play these guys. It just doesn't work. You can't play some young guys. You got 25 scholarship defensive backs. Go play some young guys. I've been saying it for the last several weeks.
A lot.
He's not going to do it. Because he wants so badly for those guys to do it. And he believes that if and when that happens, that the team will be better off for it.
Okay.
He mentioned Marcus Buford and who's the other guy who said he was coming back? There's one other guy who's coming back next year, right? Mm-hmm. Seniors who could be gone, but they're coming back. Marcus Buford's one of them. He said, I want this group of seniors like Ty Robinson and whatever to get the job in Isaac Gifford and Deshaun Singleton to get the job done. Because that way, when those next guys come take over in leadership roles next year, they have something else to do. They have something else to grasp for. A new carrot that is dangled in front of them. Right? And I just think I don't know if he's right. Frankly, I don't think he's right.
What?
Actually, I don't think he's right that it would help the team that much for them to see those guys specifically get the job done compared to the risk of just not doing it at all, because that's the risk that you run.
Right.
The risk is it doesn't happen, period. And then this carrot is still there next year, and Nebraska is still not over the hump. Now, to be fair, on the flip side, if Nebraska goes young and gets young players experience and they don't make a bowl, then that's still there next year as well. But at least you've developed. At least those guys have played and they have experience and they have something to go off of next year. And they do have, you know, a little bit of the weight that Rule talked about, the weight. Hey, I feel it. I feel the weight. Mm-hmm. I talked to former players. They carry that weight with them. They have to, unfortunately, watch it until it gets done. I'm carrying that weight with me right now. And those players, if they take over this, those young players, if they take over this year, they have to carry some of that weight through them the offseason as well. Maybe he's thinking, all right, we're going to play these old guys. If they get it done, awesome. Then we broke through. If they don't get it done, fine. Reset next year. Reset. But that has been the most curious part about this year to me, is they've leaned hard on these older guys and they're not getting the job done. And they don't have anything to show for it. And then on the backside, Nebraska football still has to have a semblance of a team next year. And those guys are going to be responsible, and they haven't developed. They don't have playing time to go underneath them. So it's just, he's too far down this road at this point. They're going with those guys.
So let me ask the stupid question then. What is he trying to teach the team by doing this? Like,
trying to teach his team that
when I'm old enough, Matt Rhule will ride or die with me, or I see that hard work pays off.
That, like, could be a side lesson.
What
that could be a side, that's like a side lesson. I think the lesson is,
wow, I can do hard things. Look at that. Look at those guys.
Yeah. Isn't that valuable? Isn't that valuable? Like, those guys have been around forever. They've been punching their heads into a wall for years and years and years. And finally, on their last opportunity, they broke through. I think that's valuable. I don't know how valuable.
I would say there isn't. I agree that the younger guys should get some more reps in game, but I also don't think there's somebody sitting on the bench right now that's like a complete game changer. That, like, oh, yeah, plug, make that one switch, and it's all over.
This is where the conversation gets really complicated,
yeah,
Josh, because you're right. You're right. But we're not talking about skill.
Right.
We're not talking about how good you are as a football player anymore. It's not about that. It's about how infected you are with the disease. Mm. Mm. That's what it is.
I didn't do that on purpose.
And so people are like, okay, well, who on the bench is going to save you right now?
Who are you going to get?
From a skill perspective, this is what I've been telling people all year long. These players are good enough. Nebraska has the players. They have the players to be so much better than they are right now. But then we sit there and we watch Malcolm Hartzog miss an interception in the end zone and undercut a route and miss, and it goes for whatever yards. And Tommy Hill, you know, who they keep touting as a whatever round draft pick. And he, like, I don't know what that play was.
And apparently in the secondary, they're just calling their own plays. Like, okay, you guys up there run that play. I'm going to do what I see.
Yeah. And those guys, you know, those guys are still out there. But hey, I mean, I've been sitting here tooting the horn for the last couple of weeks. Like, hey, I just think they got to shift. I think they got to shift for some young guys. Mm-hmm. But it ain't happening. It's not happening. Nebraska is officially ride or die with Isaac Gifford, with Deshaun Singleton, with Ty Robinson, with Nash Hutmaker, with John Bullock, and that, with Tommy Hill. And they just have to hope and pray that the other team gives them one or something. I don't know. Looking at Wisconsin, the quotes coming out of Wisconsin today, they might. I don't know.
We'll get to that. We'll get to those. I heard a coach talking over the weekend about the person asking the question said, you made a personnel swap and like things just sort of clicked. Like, why'd you make that swap? And the coach said, well, he just understood the concept better. He just understood what we were trying to do, what the goal was.
Yeah.
So I put that guy in.
See, I think
that seems like what Matt Rhule is asking of his players.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's the thing. Like, but what he sees, and I think Matt Rhule, if he's guilty of one thing, like he's guilty of these people are good people. These people are good people, mm-hmm. like really good people. And they stuck around and they're forever bonded by that. Right. But I think he's guilty sometimes of looking at how good of people they have and maybe hoping too much after the overwhelming evidence suggests that when put in sticky situations, they're not going to make the plays. That's it. He believes that they can. He believes that they can. He better be right. He better be right. Otherwise, yeah, yeah. This season is a kind of a loss. Kind of a loss.
Are you going to light your own chair on fire?
He's riding those guys.
To ride with those guys. Obviously, he is. But, like, oh, boy, that's a choice.
Yeah. Yep. Well, okay. lot there. A lot there. Joe in Vegas has a few tweets for us.
I'll bet he does. Hi, Joe.
This is easy for me. Get rid of the entire secondary except for 15 and bench 0 and 9 and let's start the youth movement now. Both suck, and so does the secondary. I don't care what anyone says. The senior class has Scott Frost stink on it, and that's why Nebraska sucks. What's the point of getting all these new guys in if he won't play them? We should have kept Frost if that's what we were going to do. What's the new carrot to suck a little less than the suck holes?
Good carrot.
Keep him playing for us.
I hear you're not supposed to eat carrots right now.
He just told you why. He just told you why he's not doing it.
Okay. Let me ask a kind of a tinfoil hatty question. You, if you don't like it, you send it right back. Is Matt Rhule digging his heels in on the I'm not, they painted me as the not the Deion Sanders guy, so I'm not the Deion Sanders guy. I'm not going to tell these old players that they suck and need to leave because I've been painted as something that.
I think he had a decision right out of the gate on that.
Yeah.
Right out of the gate. And since that decision has been made, he said we might as well just freaking do it with these guys. Didn't have to be that way.
It did not.
Didn't have to be that way, to a lot of people's point. But
it also doesn't have to be all or nothing. You can bench in some of the guys and like rotate in and out. And like,
I think so too. I agree.
Try different combinations.
I agree with that. But like, I guess you have to ask how valuable would it be to watch this particular group finally do it? And Matt Rhule is telling you a lot valuable.
Be a good story. Be fun. It would make the exhale after a potential sixth win that much greater, but like.
It's just a bit of a high wire act.
Yeah.